So welcome to my farm in Kenya. I'm Max Lemayan. I'm from Sweden, also active here in Kenya. And this is my farm where we practice agroforestry in permaculture design. And this land we have right here is a grazing field where we are improving the land to come back to savanna. This is normally, formerly, a savanna landscape, bush savanna landscape that has been so gone to be desertified. But right now, we have been managing this land for some years, taking back the grass. And the way we've been doing that is holistic management, having the animals here for a certain period of time. And then we are leaving this place to rest for some time. Some years it has been 6 months, some years the rest have been 1 year. And one benefit of that is that we are getting this tree behind me. This tree is called locally here Erangau. And that is the Samburu name. It's also found in Maasai land, but there they call it orng'uang'uenyi. Botanically, its name is Acacia Gerrardii. And when we started, we only had a few of them. I think we had 10. One very big one, and then the others were just small bushes, something like this. But now, after some years of this management, we have more than 200 of them in a small place, in a small chamber. It's like half an acre. So we can see this kind of management of grazing, it also brings these trees back. And on the other side of my fence, the land is community used. No one has fenced it yet, so it is just goats, sheep, cows utilizing. The grass is very small, it is a little bit bushy, but mostly for bush that's not very useful. And these trees are still there, and they are the same size as I found them 7 years ago. But when you look now, those trees that were the original trees, they are now big. Huh? And they are doing quite well, because here, okay, you can say this tree is growing slowly. You can say this tree is a slow grower, but when you consider that this is a grassland, the soil is very compacted, it's competing with the grass. I have not put any manure, I have not put any water. You'll realize these trees are doing quite well. And it's the only tree, actually, one of the few trees that can manage without you improving the soil first. And here you can see even a bigger one, who got a place where it's like a place maybe water is collected now during rains. And what we have been doing with this tree to maintain them, to grow straight, is that we have been pruning them. We've been pruning them with the saw for smaller branches, or the cicatrices for even smaller branches. You see? And this makes now the tree to go upwards. This tree likes spreading. It likes making a canopy. It doesn't like being straight. So we are forcing it to be straight. And we believe that this pruning is assisting the tree to go up and grow faster. And at the same time as we prune, we also get some useful material. We get some branches. So if we have a fence line where we are planting trees, we like putting this one as a protection for the goats, the sheep, the cows, so that those trees that germinate, you can even see here, we planted actually the same tree. Just by digging a little bit and putting those seeds. So now when this one are coming, the goats will like to eat this one. So these branches are helping. And they don't stay for a long time because the termites like eating this. Not when the tree is alive, the termites cannot eat it. But when the branches are dead, after some 2 to 3 years, the termites really come to eat. But that is also okay because it turns into soil. So it is very nice. The bigger branches for this tree, we normally use a power saw to cut. We found that this tree is a very good firewood. When it has dried well, it burns well, and it leaves that charcoal that makes that fire to stay long. And we even use this one to make our own charcoal. We have like a drum where we fill it, put fire, and the smoke goes, and it leaves that charcoal. So it's very useful. Brings the sticks, the firewood, the charcoal. Then again, the goats, they really love this one. These leaves. You see, the goats cannot survive on this grass alone. So in this grass, there are some shrubs that they eat and some other plants that they eat. But this is also something that they really like. And now when the trees are big like this, I can easily put the goats here. When the trees were still small, I didn't have any goats. But now the trees are big, they are protected. It can really do better. So you see that where it is tall, the leaves are big, where the goats cannot reach. But if you go and see where the goats are reaching, you can see like here, the leaves are trying to come back. And you can see there's quite a difference. Oh, sorry. There's quite a difference in the size of these leaves. So I'm leaving like a tree like this. I'm removing big branches for the tree to grow straighter. And then I'm leaving those small ones for the goats to have a feed. So it will self-prune. These branches, they will not really grow well. They'll remain the same. The goats will come and eat. And then after some time, it puts new leaves, the goats will come and eat. Until the tree is big, like these ones. This is a time now where I remove all the branches to let the tree go and grow and be tall. So even these shootings, I'll try to remove. And sometimes it also have these thorns on these thorns on the trunk. So I don't like keeping them, especially if I have children around or something. I like to take a stick like this and then just trying to just clear those branches so that the place accessible for us is clean and safe. And then those branches will grow upwards. So it's a very nice tree. It gives us a bush, kind of, that's coming up, some shade. The shade is actually helping the grass. The leaves will drop in the drought, improving the soil. When the trees are big, it gives us some seeds, which will now bring many more trees. We can see that birds like staying up in these trees, resting. And when the trees are bigger, they also put their nests inside. Then there's another big tree we can see. Just come and see. So, when the trees are big, this tree is on my neighbor's property, but it's coming over to my side. And when the tree is bigger, there's a semi-parasitic plant that do not have roots. But what they do, they connect with this tree. And then it starts growing. And this one is the very, very perfect food for even cows, goats, sheep, whatever. They love eating this. So it's a good supplement during drought, and it's easily breaking. It's a very soft wood, so you can just come and prune it a little bit. Those branches go down and the goats will be able to eat. Again, there's a lot of activity with bees. It seems bees really love the flowers of this one. And this is not the flowers for the acacia tree, but the semi-parasitic plant. I've forgotten the name, but I'll find the name and put it in the description. So that is an advantage. And the same, even this Erangau, it has its own flowers, another season, that also helps the bees. So this is also a very nice, the Erangau is a very nice tree to help with bees. We had a beehive and it was doing well. Our neighbors have bees and sometimes we buy from them. So it helps us and this community for the asali, for the honey production. So it's a very nice tree. When it becomes a bush like this, we can now start planting other trees inside here. Those trees will have the shade. Those trees will have a chance we can protect them, and we can now get a real forest. So I hope you learned something new. If you find this content interesting, there are more videos like this. Please subscribe to see the coming videos that will happen. So thank you.